Hi, kapamilya, I'm TJ Manotok, back with more headlines from BA.
Before day two of the impeachment hearings began, the White House released a full transcript of the first call of President Donald Trump congratulating Ukrainian President Zelensky. Quite notably, there was no mention of the quid pro quo that involved investigating former Vice President Joe Biden and his son, or else the U.S. would withhold military aid. Respected career diplomat, former U.S. Ambassador to Ukraine, Marie Ivanovich, was the witness for day two, and for the first time, publicly testified on an alleged concerted smear campaign against her by Trump's personal lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, among others.
These events should concern everyone in this room. Ambassadors are the symbol of the United States abroad. They are the personal representative of the president. They should always act and speak with full authority to advocate for U.S. policies. If our chief representative is kneecapped, it limits our effectiveness to safeguard the vital national security interests of the United States.
In the midst of Ivanovich's testimony, President Trump, who claimed he did not watch day one of the hearings on Wednesday, took to Twitter to attack Ivanovich. House Intelligence Committee Chair Adam Schiff asked Ivanovich for her response.
The president in real time is attacking you. What effect do you think that has on other witnesses' willingness to come forward and expose wrongdoing?
Well, it's very intimidating.
During the break, Schiff spoke to the media and called out the president for witness intimidation. This week's public impeachment hearings have been compelling for those looking to tighten a legal case against President Donald Trump.
The cover-up makes what Nixon did look almost small.
There's a lot more going on in this trial than the Nixon administration trial. There's a lot more foreign government interference, which is illegal for any election. There's a lot of obstruction of justice going on the part of the president, from preventing his senior staff from appearing in congressional testimony.
Despite mounting evidence against the president, who is accused of using the office to pressure Ukraine to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden and his son, a Fil-Am political analyst points out that the Democrats still face a hard task of convincing the majority of the American people that Trump deserved to be impeached.
The American people are very jaded against politicians and government over the last two decades. This is why the current campaign of the Democratic message to the American people is very muddy. Trump's message is very clear. This is a partisan issue. They're playing partisan politics, and I have no wrongdoing.
That's it for our Newsbreaks today, but you can stay connected to news that matters most. Just follow us on Facebook and Twitter and subscribe to our BA YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. See you next time.
This Newsbreak is brought to you by Zoom.com. Switch to Zoom.com and download the new mobile app.